This morning, some potential good news in hard-hit New York.
Again, would suggest a possible flattening of the curve.
Daily hospitalizations are down, so are ICU admissions and daily intubations. And though deaths are still rising, the increase has been stable for 2 days. Still, Governor Andrew Cuomo is warning New Yorkers not to let their guard down.
If we are plateauing, we are plateauing at a very high level, and there's tremendous stress on the healthcare system.
President Trump has now agreed to allow the 1,000-bed floating hospital, the USNS Comfort, to treat COVID-19 patients. But overnight, a crew member was isolated after testing positive for the virus. The Navy says it will have no impact on the Comfort's mission. Meanwhile, there's another 2,500 beds at the Javits Convention Center, which has been converted into a massive hospital and is now open. And possibly another 200 more beds next week at St. John the Divine, the largest cathedral in America, which is working out logistics of opening its doors to the sick. All potential relief valves for doctors like Evelina Graber, who works at a COVID-19 unit at North Shore University Hospital, and says all of her patients are seriously ill.
You can actually smell fear. You smell death.
In Harlem, frustrated medical workers are demanding more protective equipment.
To have an N95 mask every day is nothing. That's like us begging for crumbs when we need dinner.
New York City accounts for nearly a quarter of the nation's surging death toll. A funeral home in Brooklyn says it's running out of body bags.
We're overwhelmed. Overwhelmed. My staff is, they're on wit's end.
As city officials urge New Yorkers to wear face coverings when going outside, the governor is furious that some are not properly social distancing, and he has doubled the fine from not doing so from $500 to $1,000.